to Nomad in Hawaii. My journey, my vlog, whatever you want to call it, on basically my time being houseless, as I call it, or as some people call it, homeless. I live in Hawaii. I currently don't have a place, and it is by choice, partly by choice, partly by the struggle, that I chose this lifestyle. I wanted to open up this journey, this vlog series, with kind of a background, my origin story, and explaining to you how I got here, why I'm here, what is my goals, you know, what is the whole purpose of this journey that I'm doing right now. So a little bit about myself. Lived here all my life. I work as a personal trainer slash group instructor slash business owner, and I basically do it all. I drive Lyft on the side. I live a life, and I've always lived a life of kind of wanting to play by my own rules. I never followed the crowd or, you know, tried to really fit in with everyone or anyone. You know, in high school, when everybody was doing basketball, football, and all those sports, I was swimming. Yeah, I swam in these little Speedos that like this small. And I joined the swim team. After that, I became a lifeguard. That was my goal, my dream was to be a lifeguard outside of high school when I got out of high school. So did that for 7 years, got out of that, went into personal training, started my own business about maybe 12 to 13 years ago. And ever since, I've been doing that independently and just hustling and, you know, just trying to make a living like anyone else. Let me take you back to kind of where my journey began, financially at least. When I was about 23, life was good. I was working about 2 to 3 jobs, which I've always done, even to this day. I was living with my mom rent-free, but I was helping out in other ways. And I always had $3,000 in my bank account, always. So life was really good financially and just everything. Then my car at the time, which was my first car ever, was a 1987 BMW. The transmission went down. And I would say that was the beginning of the struggle, or the beginning of my financial problems. That job costed about $2,000 something just to do. And that was just for the transmission. So $2,000 something. And from then, from what I can remember, that's where my financial burden began, because I had that and I still was charging other things, you know, that I thought I needed, or maybe I needed at the time. To make a long story short, interest adds up, and before I knew it was in the thousands. And when you're young, you have a lot of offers in the mail for credit card companies, pretty much all trying to get you to sign up for their credit card. So they offer you a 0% interest for 12 months or 18 months or whatever it is, and they do a pretty good job of it. So what I did in my early 20s was I took those offers and I would max out. And then when I ran out of, you know, when I ran out of time for the promotional period, the zero interest, I then would transfer it to another credit card and then another credit card. And I would do this for years and it would build up. And I came to the point where I could no longer do it anymore. I would get turned down because my balance was a reoccurring balance. Pretty much it stuck around for too long and kind of, in a way, damaged my credit somewhat. I couldn't keep doing what I was doing, which was transferring the balance from one card to the next. After that, you know, it snowballed. You know, if I could bring you back to the present, about a year ago or so, I decided to quit my full-time job and just do my business, focus on that. I was, for a good 2 years or so, I was trying to get out of my full-time job and I wanted to go independent, which is really important to me, because I would see all my colleagues in the fitness field, you know, have their own life, have their own schedule. They would be doing everything on their own time. And I say, you know what? I'm stuck in a 9-to-5 job. Like, I want to do that. I want to be my own boss. I want to have the freedom to eat breakfast when I want and not have to rush to work, or just stay. Don't want to have to stay somewhere for 8 hours. I thought it was a waste of time. So a little over a year ago, I made the jump and I finally decided to do it. And I quit my full-time job. ever since then, I went independent. I had a 403 plan, a 403B plan, I believe. I know it's usually like 403K. This one was 403B. I had a good amount of money. So what happened was, I knew that was my backup. I was good. But then the IRS started knocking at my door. And they said, Damon, you owe $10,000-something. And I said, great. I didn't know I wasn't paying. I wasn't doing my taxes the right way, basically. I was paying taxes every single year. I do it on time in April. But I was doing something wrong on my taxes. And what happened was, I didn't know. And it built up over time. So then I got this bill in the mail and I couldn't believe my eyes. Over $10,000 I owed over the course of like at least 10 years. And it shocked me, but I said, okay, I got this down, no worries, right? I got my 403, I'm gonna cash it out and I'm gonna pay whatever penalties I have to, and then I'm gonna pay this off. Then I paid it off and I was like, great. Then, to make matters worse, the IRS sent me something else and they said, oh, by the way, you owe $7,000 more. And I was like, now I'm screwed. And the IRS will chase you down and they'll send you stuff over and over up until you actually respond to them. So here I am now, having quit my full-time job. I'm starting to drive for Lyft and I'm trying to make ends meet, and I have my rent, which is like a 900 something bucks on top of my credit card bills and everything. And I thought I was done with the IRS, but no, $7,000 more. And that $7,000 built up over time and started adding interest, and yeah. Then what would happen was, I would start to have trouble making rent. So I had to pay 900 something, and I just had a hard time paying rent. And there would be times where my account would actually go to negative because I couldn't afford it, I couldn't keep up. So my bank accounts are starting to go to negative. Now, mind you, I still have my business, so I still gotta pay my trainers. And it just kept going negative, and I kept trying to struggle, and I said, man, this is crazy. I don't know how I'm gonna do this. I was really struggling to a point where I was considering the extremes, like what can I do? Where can I cut costs? And then I came across some vlogs on YouTube and videos of people basically living out of their van, living out of their car. And it seems like this is actually a thing in the mainland, more than Hawaii, I would say. But it's kind of a thing in the mainland where people purposely live out of their car, or their trucks, or their vans, or their RVs, and they live their life that way, rent-free. So I came across these videos and I started watching it, and then I got basically the push that I needed. I saw my landlord, and he said, Damon, I got bad news. We are going to give you your 45-day notice. We're gonna give a 45-day notice to the whole first floor, which was the floor I was living on. And I'm sorry, but you guys are gonna have to either move into the more expensive renovated brand new apartments, which was like 12,000 or 1,300, or you're gonna have to find a place. I could barely afford 900 something. So I know I had no choice and I had to leave. So I got my 45-day notice, and then from there my journey began. And before I left, I had 45 days to think about it, and I kept thinking like, do I really have to move in somewhere? And I would bring this up with my friends just kind of casually and be like, you know, I've been watching these videos of people like living, you know, like a nomad or whatever you call it. I wonder if I could do the same. For a good month, okay? Now, mind you, I really tried. I was on Craigslist religiously. I looked for apartments, and then I started, you know, thinking, okay, I'm just gonna look for a room. So that's gonna be way cheaper. It's gonna be about 500 something dollars, give or take. And I just kept looking, and a lot of people didn't get back to me, or their rules were ridiculous. They were like, no overnight visitors. Hello, I gotta have a love life. No overnight visitors. You can't make any noise. You can't talk on your phone. We don't have parking. You gotta be home by a certain time. You have a curfew. I'm like, wait a minute, are you my parent? Like, I'm paying rent for this. And it started irritating me, it started getting to me, and I was like, you know what? I don't need this. I came to the point where I was like, I don't need this. I think I'm gonna try to live outside. I got my car. My car is, you know, it's doing good. It's in great shape. I have a storage unit, and I can always get another storage unit, a second one. to get all my stuff in. And the more I started thinking about it, the less crazy it seemed. Because in the beginning, it seemed pretty crazy. And I'm pretty sure like some people thought I was out of my mind, you know, for choosing this lifestyle, but I chose it. Could I have paid rent somewhere? Yeah, probably. But I chose this lifestyle and I say, you know what, I'm gonna try. So as time went on, less crazier it seemed, and I say, you know what, I'm gonna give it a shot. And here I am today, the Nomad in Hawaii vlog series, journal, diaries, whatever you want to call it. That's my story. And you know, I'm gonna take you guys on a journey. I don't know where this is gonna go. I'll be honest with you, I don't know. I don't know if I'm gonna succeed. I don't know if I'm gonna fail, but I'm gonna take you on this journey with me. And I'm not gonna debut this vlog until like a year or 2 years later, out of safety reasons, also because, you know, I am a little ashamed. I own a business. I don't want my clients to think like, oh great, he's homeless and this and this. And you know, they mean well. A lot of people mean well, but I don't like when people start, you know, like feeling sorry for you, or they're like, oh, you know, Damon, I got a room, or how can I help? I appreciate it all. It's just, I feel kind of weird. Like, I don't want to put my burden, my choice on anyone. So this is where my journey begins. Day one. I don't know what's gonna happen. I don't know what's ahead of me, but I'm pretty sure and I have confidence that everything is gonna be okay. And you guys get to join in on this adventure with me. So I hope you guys enjoy what you see. I hope you follow me. It's gonna be one hell of a ride. I hope you can somehow be inspired. Not necessarily having to move on your own or doing the same thing I do, but just kind of thinking outside of the box. Sacrificing and doing whatever it takes to get to wherever you want to go. Now, this is extreme to some people, I understand that. But for me, this is the only way that I can pay off my bills and I can afford to live. Because in Hawaii, it's not easy to make it. Anywhere in the world, I believe, is not easy to make it. So I'm doing what I have to do to survive. And I'm gonna learn some things along the way, and I'm just gonna figure it out. I don't have everything planned, but I'm gonna try. My goal, pay off my bills. Get all my bills out of the way, get to a point where I don't have to worry about my bank account going negative or struggling. I wanna live comfortable. That's the main goal. So again, I hope I can inspire you guys. I hope you guys enjoy this journey. Stay tuned, there's more videos to come. This is Nomad in Hawaii. And I'll see you guys again soon. Birthday.